A while back on the channel, I made a video about my experience riding my bike around the world. One of the most harrowing experiences I had was when a rainstorm, and I mean a full-on crazy thunderstorm, hit me while I was riding my bike over the Devil's Slide. At the time, there was no tunnel, and there was crazy traffic on that road. I was getting pelted with hail, and well, I was right on the edge of the cliff. It was pretty damn scary. Cars were honking at me. And frankly, I looked down below and I saw, at the time, wreckage. I don't know what it was, but it wasn't a Tesla because this was more than 10 years ago. Now, I talked about my experience on the channel. And I talked about my experience when Mary Lou, a lady who I had never met in my life, stopped her van. She'd actually driven all the way home. She'd seen us. Driven home to her house, picked up the right car so she could pick up mine and my wife's bikes, driven back to the Devil's Slide, stopped her car right on the side of the cliff and said, "Quick, get in. It's dangerous here." We got in the car. She took us home to her house and there was a crazy storm for the next 3 days and we stayed there. This was the kindness of a stranger. Well, now a story has come to light of a Tesla, unfortunately, going down that same exact spot where I was stranded with my wife and crashing down below. It fell 250 feet, but something remarkable happened. Hello, my friends. Welcome to the channel. I'm the Electric Viking. Great to see you. Welcome to all the new subscribers. Welcome back, everyone else. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you to our Patreon supporters and our YouTube members. Now, when I rode my bike around the world, I saw many crashes. And I'm talking some crazy ones where I'd seen trucks go over cliffs. We rode our bikes through Indonesia, through Southeast Asia. We saw some pretty insane stuff that you just think, what happened there? That is, whatever happened there, that is insane. Now, one time we were riding through Thailand and we saw an accident had happened. We didn't actually see the accident happen, but we saw the cars. And I approached one of the cars. It wasn't a Tesla. There was, like I said, no Teslas around at the time. And the car was crushed. I looked in the back seat. There was blood and there was children's toys. And that stuck with me. That really stuck with me ever since. I can't really forget the image. It was pretty clear what had happened. A truck had actually driven over the top of the car. It crushed everyone inside of it. This Tesla vehicle, well, it wasn't driven over by a truck, but it was basically pretty destroyed. It fell 250 feet. I mean, what's that? About 70, 80 meters. That's an insanely long way to fall. Now, I saw vehicles in Laos that had fallen that far off cliffs, but I had no idea. I just assumed everyone was dead. However, when first responders found the Tesla vehicle, there was four people inside of it. And they assumed that, well, as I did, everyone would be dead. That's an insanely long way to fall. Now, if you fell 70 or 80 meters, right, off a cliff onto rocks, yeah, you would be dead. There's just no way of avoiding that. Anyhow, they got down this cliff, found in the car, there was four people in there, two children in the back seats. Remarkably, those children were almost unscathed, had very, very minor injuries. In the front, the parents, the mum and the dad, had some serious injuries, but they are alive and it looks as though they will make a recovery. Now, this is one of the things that happens when you have massive improvements to a product. And I'm not talking just a product. I'm not saying just Teslas could potentially save your lives, but the entire automotive industry has massively improved the product, massively improved the safety standards of vehicles. And honestly, part of that improvement is actually electric cars. A lot of electric cars are much more structurally sound than gasoline powered vehicles. And this EV, this Tesla, well, guess what? Battery hadn't set itself on fire. And in fact, incredibly, it saved the lives of these four people. This is a very rare occurrence. Everyone there was shocked. It was quite an amazing event that this has happened. The devil slide nearly took these lives, but somehow the incredible structural rigidity of this vehicle saved the lives of the occupants. Now, you're probably thinking, oh, this is a Tesla autopilot, full self-driving debacle. It must have driven itself off the road. Well, turns out it didn't. Unfortunately, the driver of the vehicle, I'm assuming the father, was just driving too fast. Maybe not paying attention. Maybe just doing that thing where, you know, your kids are arguing in the back and you look around for a second and you go, shut up, kids, stop. And then all of a sudden, you're off the road. And imagine the feeling. Imagine the feeling. They would have had long enough to have a little mini conversation. And that's a long way to fall. It wouldn't have happened within, you know, a split second. I mean, maybe not a conversation, but long enough to realize what had happened. Long enough to wonder, will my family be dead? Well, fortunately, they're not. Now, the state of the Tesla's wreckage initially did not make rescuers optimistic at all about the survival of anyone in the car. But upon realizing that the vehicle's passengers were actually alive, the rescuers went into overdrive, extricating two children, a 9-year-old boy and a 4-year-old girl immediately. The children's injuries were pretty mild. They're going to be okay. Now, the rescue kind of reminded me of what it was like when I was there. Apparently, it was a difficult rescue conducted in bad weather and in really challenging terrain. But despite the helicopters being at risk themselves, rescuers were able to extricate the two adults inside the Tesla safely and the children as well. And the adults were rushed to a trauma center. They're now recovering. They will pull through this. They are going to be okay. Battalion Chief Brian Pattinger later told the media that the results of the accident were remarkable. They were blown away. We come out here, unfortunately, all too often for things like this. And this was nothing short of a miracle that they survived, Pattinger said. Robin Johnson, a witness to the accident who called 911, shared to the NBC Bay Area that the electric Tesla vehicle seemed to be driving way too fast, at least according to what she could tell from her rearview mirror. Johnson said that she saw the Tesla go over the edge of the road and straight down the cliff. Personally, I'm going to say, I can't say for sure whether this would happen in another car or not. But I think it's safe to say, considering all the instances we've seen, all the times now we've seen where there's been really remarkable, miraculous recoveries, survivals from crazy crashes like this involving Tesla cars, that, you know, considering Teslas are rated the safest cars in the world by pretty much every organization globally that's tested them, well, if you're most concerned about safety, Tesla might be the car you want to buy. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.